Yeah, what it do? What it do? You know, I know who I am. They are the barber. What's going on?
With the empty fence about him.
Marquita.
Paris.
JR.
What's going on? No, we missing one today, y'all. He couldn't make it today. So shout out to Shano the barber, too. So what's going on with y'all? What y'all been up to this weekend?
Working per usual.
Yeah. That's about it.
Yeah, it's pretty much the same here too. I ain't do too much. I'm trying to see, what did I do? Oh, nothing. I just worked. Yeah, I just worked. I just went to work.
Okay, what happened at the shop?
Nothing.
I couldn't be messy.
Not my barbershop.
Something happened.
Not your barbershop.
I'm the only one at my barbershop right now. Oh. No, I got another barber too, but he only work on Saturday and Sunday.
He ain't messy.
This weekend. Mm-mm. Oh, he a white guy. He white.
So what, they can't be messy?
No, I ain't saying that. But he an older white guy.
Older.
Yeah, he ordered me
mullets and stuff.
Oh,
toupees.
No, he do everything I do. He just ordered me.
That's not racist. They said black people can't be racist. Is that
that's
true?
A lie?
No,
that's,
it's not.
Yes, we can. No, we can't be racist. How?
We can't.
I can't really think of the reasons why they said it, but
because you don't have no.
When I was thinking, power. No ultimate power.
Yeah. The minority. We can't hold us back.
Oh, okay. In that aspect, I agree with that.
You'll never think deep.
Yeah, with some people who have broken down pretty good.
Wow.
Y'all see Drake coming August 3rd?
Yeah, I'm going.
I know you going.
I'm going.
You know you ain't going to miss no event.
None. Not a one. Not Drake. Not Lil Baby. None of that.
No, you ain't.
I'm already plugged in for Lil Baby.
Who cares?
I do. I'm already
plugged in.
Don't be a hater.
Shannon would have definitely said something sweet. Shannon, we know you won't hear somewhere. Hey.
But no, I'm going to both. Though you going?
No.
Why?
I don't know. It depends. I'm going to Lil Baby.
I mean, I can see you don't mess with the club scene, but this is a concert at the Pfizer Forum. Like,
I ain't go see this.
I didn't either. I'm salty. I didn't go either.
You listen to Tink?
I mean, I want. Yeah.
No, you don't.
I don't listen to it.
You wasting your time.
I don't listen to it. I would have took my baby mama.
I like her. Okay. No, you trying, my to, baby get, mama trying to get back in the house?
Yeah,
you tripping. You ain't get the ticket.
No, she was here.
You
I didn't
up.
Know she was coming.
Mama put another a couple more months to that.
She wasn't here. She was in Chicago.
Yeah, but he
same
the
thing.
Tickets.
That's the same
and he
thing.
He trying to get back in the crib, so he done messed up.
Did y'all go to the comedy show?
No. I found out late.
Spend all my life working.
All your life
day
working.
In and day out.
I had got the memo real late, so I was irritated. Because I wasn't prepared, type shit.
I mean, they've been
they've been
promoted all month, but okay.
You heard the promotions? I heard it through China. I didn't hear them.
Yeah,
I've been hearing about this since January. I knew about this.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Y'all ever miss somebody that y'all know that wasn't good for you, but you still miss them anyway?
Yeah.
No, not really.
What? You're trying to make it sound toxic. No, I don't. Yes, you did, JR.
No, once I'm done with somebody, I'm done. I'm pretty much done with them.
You miss somebody too.
But what about before you done with them? And they not good for you. No, they're not good for you, but you just
miss somebody.
Yeah, I guess you could say that.
Do I miss somebody?
Uh-huh.
No.
Oh no.
So what made you say that then?
Because I was just asking. Because I seen a post earlier on Instagram. It was talking about missing people that you know aren't good for you. They'd be like, well, why do you miss them? I guess it's some type of like soul attachment.
So the word soul ties and soul attachment is so deep to me.
Is it?
I think it's deeper than just
it's I miss true. This person it's and crazy. I keep
running into this person. You know, the universe works for different reasons, but
oh my goodness, soul let's ties, not talk about that.
Soul ties is really, really real and it's deep.
Is it?
You yeah. ever been trying to like get over somebody and then all of a sudden like you never seen this person like in the places that you meet and all of a sudden like you just running into this person, seeing this person or this person know this person all of a sudden, like what do y'all think that is? Y'all think that's the universe trying to align y'all together?
Yeah, I agree. Yeah. Yeah.
You ever had period sex?
What?
One time.
I'm trying to talk about soul ties.
You went what? That's right.
No, one time I tried it. It was
no, I mean, and I don't be we ain't gonna
I ain't gonna go into detail.
Yeah, gotta,
I ain't gonna go into
you
detail.
You ever had soul ties?
I don't know, have I?
I'm just asking.
You think there's a connection?
What?
Period sex and soul ties?
Yeah, I think it is.
That's pretty much what she was getting at.
If that's the case, then yeah.
See, it get to getting real with them. Y'all soul
know,
ties.
I don't know which Bible verse it is. Like, I'm probably gonna be throwing out a lot of Bible stuff, but I don't be knowing everything. But just bear with me. So, it was a woman, like, she couldn't stop bleeding or whatever in the Bible. And when Jesus touched her, like, he healed her, but he ended up being weak because of it for a while. Like, it made him weak for her to touch him while she was on her period.
Why you think that is?
I don't know. I need to do my research, don't I? It's them soul ties talking about.
Shit, all he did was touch her.
I'm actually scared of soul ties. What about y'all?
Yeah, so maybe you're not supposed to be doing that.
Yeah, I'm scared of soul ties for real.
Why?
Because that shit is really real.
Because you can have a soul tie with somebody that's not good that for you, and it's hard to break that.
But it'd be signs before. It reached that y'all,
like what?
I don't know, it'd be sad because we're trying to often ignore.
Yeah, but the soul tie is what keep you like into that person,
yeah.
Even though you know it's something that's not good for you.
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
So you think men care more about the person they lying to or the person they telling the truth to?
I'm gonna have to say the person. Could be. They lying to because the person they telling the truth to, they like it is what it is. This is 12 years.
For 12 years.
Damn.
Wow.
Damn. What the fuck? She ain't died. That's a lot of blood.
She went into a depression.
Women are some strong people.
Yeah, I agree. Years. I definitely agree y'all is so strong.
And then when she touched them, when she touched Jesus, she stopped bleeding.
Damn, that's crazy. I'm going to have to go read that in the scripture.
We're going to have to.
Yeah, the Bible got some good stuff in it, even though I don't know. Some people don't believe in the Bible and
stuff in it, but
some stuff I feel like is not right.
It's so see that's the thing about the Bible. It's so good that a lot of the stories is unbelievable. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, damn, this shit really happened for real.
12 years though she has spent all she had on physicians, no one could cure her. She came up behind Jesus and touched his fringe of his clothes, and immediately her hemorrhage stopped.
Damn.
Jesus,
all she touched was.
Yeah, he is.
The
shout out to Jesus.
A piece of his clothing.
Touched his drip.
Yep.
Touched his drip.
Touched his drip.
Damn. Well, I should be able to heal this. My drip.
Oh, please.
Oh, my God.
That's
Shit.
Dang, that's I don't believe in Jesus.
No.
You said okay, so? I believe in a God and a higher power, but I don't believe in Jesus. Like, I think that's all made up. That whole entire, what happened, most of it. I believe more so, if you're going to compare the two, I believe more so into the African science versus Jesus, because they took that and made it to a white person, white wool.
But he ain't white, though. If you read the Bible, he's not white.
No, he's not, but that's what they say.
No, that Jesus is really, the pictures that you see of Jesus is really
darker than
this,
me?
This a gay lover we? Of a king. I'm serious. Look it up.
It's like Michelangelo?
I forgot
who painted it.
Yeah, he painted it.
It was his gay lover.
And they told him to push that out there real. As Jesus. Yeah.
Damn.
But that picture of Jesus is right? That person. It's not the actual Jesus.
Yeah, it's just be, you know, it's kind of weird to me. Well, the character.
Yeah,
yeah, I was gonna say that, but like, I definitely know it's a higher power.
But you believe in the higher power
for sure. Okay. I just don't believe in like the what they push on us on every corner in the hood. You know, that big face is all in the hood.
Yeah,
but not
Christianity
in
was pushed up on
it,
us
it,
real
it,
tough. When we got
any of the religions, like.
I'm not religious.
Okay.
I believe in a higher power. Yeah,
but
I did growing
not
up
anymore. I yeah, believe in God, and I believe in Jesus too, but I don't like believe in any certain religion. Like, mm-hmm. I don't roll with any certain religion just because this far. I'm not saying that I might not tomorrow or whatever, right. But as I'm learning, like, I just feel like it's a lot of wrong stuff in every religion. It's a lot of good stuff, and it's a lot of wrong stuff.
We more of gods and goddesses than we know of. Like, we real. Well, I'm learning to get
we
more
attuned
with.
We have God within us.
Like, we are more powerful than we think, than we know. And I'm just not learning on all that. But this side make more sense to me than the other stuff. For us melanated people. You believe in Jesus?
Yes,
you,
I
ain't playing.
Yeah, I believe
Jesus
yeah,
or
I believe in God. I believe it's the higher power.
So, yeah, I said, do you think that... the man care more about the person he lying to or the person he telling the truth to?
I answered that before they interrupted me.
You did.
I said as a man, I think he loved the one he lying to versus the one he telling the truth to.
Love?
Oh, yeah.
He loved the one he lying to?
Yeah.
Why you say that?
Because
he don't want to hurt her feelings.
Right, because he care about her feelings. You know, the other one,
he gonna lie to her and
tell her the truth. Like, oh, well, if you leave, it don't matter. I get what you're saying.
That's a fact.
Oh. Okay, so I have a question. So, so men, like, that y'all be getting commended on how many women y'all sleep with and stuff like that. And I'm just wondering, like, do it feel good to be faithful? Like, you in a faithful relationship and you not cheating or nothing and you just with this person.
Do it feel good to be faithful
or do you be feeling like you missing out on something? Because, you know, when y'all be in a relationship, y'all homeboys be hitting y'all up like, oh, your wife got you stuck in the house, bro. Like, then they think it's funny or whatever.
Definitely.
Do y'all be feeling like y'all missing out on something by being faithful or is it a good feeling for y'all?
I think it's a little bit of both. I think it's a little bit of both. At times it do feel good, but at times it's like, damn, you know, so I gotta give up doing this, I gotta give up doing that. So, I mean, it's a struggle. It's a day-to-day struggle.
Poor man.
Why is it always something?
What you mean?
Men could be like, all right, he cheating because she not nasty enough. That happens. He cheating because she's not cleanly enough. You get that? He's cheating because... No, it's just always an excuse from what I know. Yeah, I'm just throwing out stuff just randomly. He cheating because she...
don't clean
not
up.
Financially
or
stable.
He just cheating.
Or
she
like,
nags.
Sometimes it don't be...
That's what I was getting to. Like, it's always a reason. Well,
sometimes it don't...
You get on people's ass, they make it seem
okay,
like it's
all the time.
Like, my woman perfect.
Sometimes
I just need to go touch something else every once in a while.
Those are just made up excuses in some cases.
Men are physical beings. Mm-hmm. So sometimes we just act. We just act. And that'd be that.
And then you can't forgive your girl if she just act. What if she just wants to sleep with that nigga just because it's like, damn.
It's different. It's different.
It is. Because it hurt.
No.
So even though y'all.
It hurt. But I think that cheating, you know what I'm saying, it's different. You know, from man to woman, it's different. Because a man can cheat and it just be that.
So y'all look at y'all woman as sacred. Like nobody should touch your woman. There you go. But
you
y'all like the hoes and stuff.
But you touched the other women. No, we don't
like
her.
The hoes, though.
It's like
niggas don't really a double like standard. Hoes. We like
y'all like to exactly. That's what I mean. I don't mean like y'all want to go be in a relationship with them. I mean,
it's a physical thing. I just said it's a fit.
But that's
and that'd be fine with y'all. Like y'all, if y'all had a bad bitch to fuck every single day for 7 days, like you'll do that no matter you don't know who she been with or whatever, and that's okay. But your woman. If you find out she done been with somebody or whatever, one person, then like your whole view like of her is just like that.
It's over.
It turns negative.
A wrap. It's
but you
over.
Get the risk bringing her something
it's
home.
Over. It's a wrap.
Having kids.
But
on her,
how do you how could you feel so nasty about your woman? But you don't feel nasty about sleeping with
I'm not talking about you, but I know you go sleep with
somebody, like you know, this girl's promiscuous. Like she
that's where I'm going to sleep
all over
she
and all out. But you don't feel that. But that's you don't I, feel nasty. Like how you feel nasty doing
why
your
would
woman?
I feel nasty
how do you I'm, listen? How do okay, you feel ahead, nasty doing your woman? I mean, after she been with one person, but you don't feel nasty about doing this girl up who been with 10 people
because. That's not my girl.
Selfish.
This but you're still girl. Doing it. Like you still with this.
You risking bringing her STDs, getting
no,
somebody
I'm not.
Else pregnant.
I'm not,
yes, you are.
I'm wrapping it up. I'm making sure I'm wrapping it up.
I don't understand.
And how guaranteed are
how
condoms?
Could you
easy to understand.
You look like feel you nasty get, about your woman who cheated with one person.
You can get some head from a woman
and
get on the
not feel nasty about a that's woman who you know right. sleep with multiple men all the time.
Because,
like you don't feel how you don't feel nasty about her, but you feel nasty about your woman.
That's not my girl. This is
but you still risk it.
But she didn't slept with
10
people and your girl ain't slept with nobody. Like
I don't care what she do on her spare time.
So some things we just won't understand.
Say she didn't step out and slept with one person.
Basically.
So some things we just won't understand.
No.
Because how the hell you going to say, that's not my girl, I don't care. And then y'all saying, the woman y'all lie to is the one y'all care more about. Like, that don't make sense.
It does make
sleeping
sense.
Sleeping around and risking bringing her STDs.
To
and
us, it makes sense. I'm
everything under the sun. But when she sleep with one person, it's just disgusting to your soul. But sleeping
you
with all these
can't touch her no more ever again.
Why, because when women cheat, it's an attachment there. It ain't just physical. It's
how come
attachment
it can't
there.
Be? It could be sometimes.
That's
you ain't never
rare.
Heard of a
that's
woman
rare.
Who's
I think
not
less
good.
In that's this rare. Day and age is not really like that as much anymore.
I don't know.
Don't have like feelings like they used to. Like people don't care about shit these days.
No. The girls is tough. They aggressive now. They bold.
They talking about they it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 500 niggas.
They got
they
one
care.
Leaving on God, one leaving out the front, one coming through the back. They tell you what they want.
Them hoes though, we talking about.
We talked about
women, not,
but them the ones y'all risking
hoes.
Sleeping with, which for y'all girl?
You said what?
Then the ones y'all risking it off.
Who is y'all?
Oh, well, them.
Okay, there you go. Okay. Speaking in general.
Talking about anybody okay. specifically.
Yeah, so, that, I mean, I get what y'all saying. It's, you know, it's definitely.
We should start knocking some sense into some niggas, right?
How? How would you do that?
I'm just playing.
I don't think things are going to get better. I think it's going to be just a small percentage of people that's going to be on that, you know, straight and narrow path.
But it's been like that, though.
Yeah.
It's been like that. You know what I'm saying?
That's why I said I don't think it's gonna change. That's just the way
it's
it is.
Be, yeah, it's just the way it is.
I guess you just got to find what works for you, huh?
You think, I know more men that risk it all than more men that But no, I'm cool. And I know y'all friends will geek y'all up to risk it all versus like, no.
See, bro. I really don't have no friends. So.
Oh, because they'll let y'all sit down when y'all sitting around.
I mean, I got associates. I got niggas who I associate.
The nigga with the friends, he didn't make it today.
Yeah, the one with the friends. Oh. He ain't here today. Like,
why your guy didn't stop you from making his decision? Now you all depressed and sad. And
right. Do your guys be like, or have you ever told any of your guys like, dad, you got a good ass, or why you fucking with this raggedy ass bitch?
No, they to do. Be honest, I'm out of my business. I've been talking to my business. I don't say nothing.
You funny as hell, for real.
Tommy, you said,
like,
yeah.
For real. Like, I'm out of my business.
We do that to as females.
Niggas gonna be niggas, so shit.
My guy's like,
just don't say you was with me.
I wouldn't get upset someone had that coochie before I got her.
We talking about why y'all
just a nigga turning.
You know what? I take that back. I take that. I got a brother, right? I got a brother. He was, I'm talking about this nigga was reckless. I'm talking about reckless, dog. No,
people, they usually don't calm down until something bad happens. Like they get the chick pregnant or something.
You need to chill out. This is a good chick. Like, bro, what did you do it? He
on fire.
And now he regretted. Like, he lost her. He, you know, he lost his two kids. They moved out of state on him.
Jay, every Monday at 5.
So yeah, so but yeah, I had to tell him because he was just
what do Corcor.
Did he stop?
So what you mean, Rick? Huh? Like,
did he stop?
He lost her.
But it was too late. Was,
yeah. No, by the time he stopped, it was over with. Like, you know what I'm saying?
He lost this girl.
She packed up.
I agree. But what?
But I wonder, so after that mistake, did he try to, I know, like, it take a minute to, like, find somebody who, for you, you gonna still mess around or whatever, but did he find anybody after that and, like, make a change? Yeah. Did he try to change?
No, he's been single ever since. Because he
full-time hoe.
Deep down, he tried to get his baby mama back.
He tried to get her back.
Deep down, he tried to get it. Like, he didn't.
Hey, sister.
And not to put, for bro. You need to.
And not to put his business out there. But he did some reckless.
You trying to get back?
No.
Don't follow him.
No.
This hopefully his baby mama don't see this. Who he trying to get back with?
That nigga did some so bad. He faked his death, all type of shit.
What?
I'm telling you, listen. I'm telling you, he faked his death.
He ain't right. He said, fuck jail and studio life.
I'm telling you.
He went past the jail.
I'm telling you.
What's the boy name?
I'm telling you.
The one he said, I had died.
Jacket down.
Oh, jacket down.
I died and came back.
He said, I had died.
Yeah. But Ben Hip got a tour behind that shit.
Did he fake his death? Like,
he just told her he was dead.
He told her.
She said, I had died.
I'm dead, bitch.
No, he texted her.
Oh, I would have had to.
No, he texted her like he was me. I'm like, no, why the fuck you put me in that shit? Like, no, we fell out behind that shit.
Because
I told her, I'm like,
now she gonna be mad at you.
Right, exactly. I'm like,
she's never gonna think that it was you that did it. She ain't gonna never believe it was him that actually sent the message.
Dude, that shit ain't gonna work.
She's not never finna forgive him. Like, nigga, when I take you back, I'm gonna.
When you read out of lies,
and it didn't help his situation. I'm like
if you a cheater, I would think people that cheat all the time would have some good lies already set up.
But bro, like, definitely had a good woman. Like, he didn't have to.
I died. I'm dead. Like,
he caught. And he was just. He had a side chick. He had a side chick. He just couldn't let go. And I'm like, bro, come on, you tripping.
So he got to suffer and deal with those consequences.
And then he probably had, like we were just talking about, a soul tied to his side chick.
He definitely, yeah.
He and couldn't let it go.
He raw dogged her on that time of the month.
Soul ties. Goodness, here we go with that again.
But yeah, he definitely
those soul ties be for real.
Yeah, so I've been there before. I had to tell bro, like, you need to chill out, bro.
So
but that's the only person I've ever done that to, like.
Bro, when the man told her he was dead from your number, did he come back like when she?
I don't know because
what did you say?
Fell out behind that. I'm like, bro.
Oh, so you don't know what happened? How he came back and said, "No, I'm not dead. I'm alive."
Takes a call me. I'm going to tell her it was a lie, bro. Because I'm not
like you ain't think about this afterwards, like. tomorrow.
Really no, she found out he was lying. He found out that he was lying, and they I guess they got into it.
I wouldn't be able to text somebody like that. I told him that shit was reckless.
I told him that one go. I'm like, he childish. That's not gonna work, bro.
He childish as fuck.
That's the worst.
Like, listen,
I died. Like, okay, come yeah, pull up. I'm gonna show you.
Yeah, told her he died. I'm like, bro, what is you doing, bro?
He texted to her.
He inboxed her.
Like, you know, okay, so imagine somebody telling you that, right?
He inboxed her on my
Facebook. What are you gonna say to you after
like
this?
My brother died.
Yeah, that's what it was. Some shit like that. I'm like, bro, what is you doing? Like,
what's he gonna say after?
Right. Yeah, like what the fuck?
To this day, ain't no can't pussy see the kids because of that shit.
He unstable. he unstable.
Ain't no pussy. Ain't I don't see like, no coochie being worth that.
Something wrong with him for real.
And now he want her back.
I think that's too extreme. Do you think
he stopped messing with the side chick?
Oh yeah, hell yeah. I mean, eventually,
motherfuckers do all that and still be dibbing and dabbing.
Yeah, that's yeah.
He probably told y'all he do. He fucking with her now, probably. Shit, he risked it.
No, I know he don't. He fuck with somebody else now.
So that brings me to this question:
other people
moved on,
right? Multiple people.
Is it cheating if you buy your coworker breakfast?
Yeah.
It depends on your intent.
If you're in a relationship, yes, that's cheating. If you are in a relationship, that's cheating.
And then you never know how the other person gonna take it. Even if you are just trying to be like, I'm gonna buy you lunch. This just a friendly gesture, so I don't want to eat in front of your face. That may be my mindset,
right?
Or the person's mindset. But the other person who you buying a breakfast from, they might be like, oh, they like me.
Ain't nobody gonna buy something like that. That's a gesture of like leadership, you know, like
camaraderie. Now if I buy it, like.
No, y'all know what I'm saying.
What if you just
all of us?
What if you only? What if you only work with one person?
Like Marquita, what you want for Wendy's? That kind of shit.
What if you only work with one person though?
Yeah, like you, we co-workers and
that's cheating.
You done bought me some breakfast. Like,
nah, that's cheating, friend.
Even if you had, if you didn't have any ill intentions or ill will about
it, but it's cheating if you take it too.
If she's single, we don't know her story.
I said if she's single.
What if you hungry? What if you was starving to death? He said, shut the fuck up.
Yes, it is, T.Y. That's cheating.
They got women that say that's no.
Oh, they said, no,
it's not. It's not.
Yes, it is. It's see, not all cheating. Y'all cheaters. That's why.
It depends. No. It's just breakfast.
What if a person hungry and it ain't payday and they don't have the funds?
See, Michelle making excuses.
My chick.
She making excuses to cheat. That's what it is.
Everybody is doing the same thing.
Buy another nigga lunch.
I was gonna ask you from that way.
Nigga, please.
So it's cheating if you buy
look at that
your co-worker some breakfast.
What?
And my girl flipped out.
Exactly.
She was even more pissed because it had cheese on it.
Exactly.
You know I like cheese.
That's
too.
That's cheating. You can't do that.
I was gonna ask from that point of view. Like,
hell yeah, I would be mad as a motherfucker. Like, why are you buying this nigga lunch?
Because maybe some people saying it's innocent because if they receive it, it's innocent.
No, you could have brought that to me.
So, Michelle, would your man be able to buy another woman breakfast?
I'm just not kind-hearted.
Oh, you're just not kind-hearted.
So she agreed with me?
I guess so. You agree with him, right? Because...
So what you think? You think it's okay?
No.
Okay, what you think?
If I did it, I probably would never say nothing.
Of course you would.
Because I don't...
Because that's cheating.
I'm not sure. Like that, bro. The only reason why I would think that it was not okay because, like I said, you don't know, even though you may just be doing a friendly gesture, you don't know how that other person is taking
it. Taking it, right.
So they may be like, you just want to buy this person lunch because I don't want to eat in your face.
Right.
But now, that person be like, oh, lunch, she bought me some lunch. Oh, she like me.
What up, my boy? What's happening?
But if you like, so easy that you're gonna be able to draw for like a breakfast sandwich,
right?
No, that's
they be working their way
the
up.
Start of it, right?
Yeah, they could be like,
start of it, like,
she,
you buy,
but ultimately, it started with breakfast
with
sandwich.
Some breakfast. That's why
Then the next thing you might do, you might be like, I'll take this trash out for you. I'll finish cleaning up and you can go ahead. Like, oh, he did something else nice for me now. Oh, they feeling me.
Okay, see, you was asking to get your head buzzed, Nika. She said, man, she cooked and brought me breakfast and I thought it was cool, so I returned the favor. No sneaky intent. She cooked and brought you a meal in a Tupperware bowl.
She cooked.
That's too much.
A meal for you. No.
That's too much. Now you just too friendly.
Yeah. Yeah,
you gonna cook this
shit?
That
was cheating. Sorry.
Man, now that would have made me mad.
It's hard to pass up food, though.
That would have made me mad.
That's what I was saying. Like, what if you were really hungry and you just and it was smelling so good, you just want to take it. So you cheating if you take it.
What if it's a client though?
Shit.
Ooh,
how you putting this scenario?
That happened all the time.
How you putting this scenario? Because I have female clients that's not gay by a long shot.
I'm talking about
so you're talking about men. Oh, so if you're gonna put it in that perspective, that's cheating.
Okay.
So a man bring you a burger and be like, hey, you look hungry.
Keep it 100.
And you hungry?
Now listen. So I ain't trying to contradict myself.
You be like, oh,
you gonna take it though, right?
2 o'clock. You ain't ate all day.
I ain't trying to contradict myself, but this happened before, right?
But what?
Let me put yours on the thing. So he's so nosy. So look, I had that happen before. Like my client, he was coming for some wicks. And he knew it was gonna take a long time. So when he came in, he was just throwing his food away. He was like, damn.
It's a client though. I don't think that's a bad thing.
It wasn't because his girl was there, all of that. He didn't mean nothing by it. He was just saying, like, I was about to grab you something, but you ain't answer, so I ain't know what you wanted. And then I just said fuck it and came in. Cause he knew it was gonna take a long time. So he was being nice that way. But
see, if a client do it though, I don't think that's bad either.
So, I don't think that's bad either. I ain't gonna lie.
It's a touchy subject.
It is. I mean, it's definitely a touchy subject.
Like if you at work, Tommy, and you got a wife or a woman, and your coworker decides she want to cook and bring you some lunch too.
It's happening.
That's cheating.
How you know people be bringing you stuff? Because no, you just laugh. You ain't even deny it.
No, man. They do tip a lot though, but no, that's that. No.
I don't know. No, I ain't gonna say it depends.
You cut a lot of single moms.
Is that bogus with me saying if you got clients, that's okay, but if you work a 9-to-5, that's not okay? That's
no, bogus.
So you're working in the factory and y'all at lunch and you bring somebody. Yeah.
That's too personal for me.
Yeah, that's a different atmosphere.
Exactly. Yeah.
Especially like Danica, she got somebody cooking her a whole meal.
A whole meal.
Put it in the Tupperware and everything.
Which means you thought about
that's personal.
You thought about
that's
her.
Personal. I don't care what
that's about the whole personal. About the whole time back there. Like
I'm making this gonna be good.
Yeah, like you thought about that. You put some thought into that the day before.
Right.
You thought about that. Then you packed the lunch and brought it to me. Right. Probably packed it all cute.
You're good Tupperware.
Hey, y'all.
No.
Okay, no. We ain't thinking about you scary. Y'all, Kay was supposed to be a special guest on here.
Shannon isn't even here today, so you could have said
yeah, move
seat.
Around.
Shannon, fam. He was saving you some space. No, he wasn't. It's just what that. That's just what happened.
Yeah, it is.
The difference is...
Because a coworker...
You get one break at work. So you're going to, that's too personal to me. Like if I'm doing different clients here and this service might take a while or you was just randomly somewhere and you on your way there, that's different. You just being nice to a person. But for you to get one break and you're going to bring this, you're going to order them some lunch and bring them some lunch. That's too personal for me.
Ordering one thing, bringing some like lasagna or some shit.
Ooh, you took your time. That's cooked personal. The noodles.
Took your time with that.
Oh, this is some little shit I whipped up.
Yeah. What it do, BP?
Everybody said, what's up to Marquita? Don't nobody love me? Or JR?
KO, we can't take your advice.
That do come up, though. He said, like, hey, you ever had German chocolate cake? I ain't never had it. I don't like that shit. Wait, you have mine. Shit.
Now, like, the way you put that,
people do want you to try their food.
Because you know how to get to a dude.
It might seem innocent, though.
Yeah.
But like, yeah, you don't know a person's
know the
real
intent.
Intent.
Yeah,
like inside
the
their heads.
So if you were in a relationship, it's just best to, I'm good.
I brought her
well,
Danica,
you didn't kill the confusion. You made it worse. Sorry.
Right, you made it worse.
You didn't kill the confusion.
That was cheating. Y'all was food cheating.
You actually made her a little insecure.
I love this show. I never.
Hey, Tyrone.
Oh, you can make sure
Yeah, he said alone.
Somebody said hey to me. He heard me.
Yeah, the nigga, you didn't make it no better, dog.
Yeah,
no.
Right, you did not make it no better. That's actually why you got cussed out.
Y'all probably was about to fight because you don't see the harm, and you probably really kept trying to explain.
This make that scenario. Money, boo. Don't let that money make you.
Don't do me like that. Yeah, whatever.
We doing you like that.
It's I'm all not, right, I'm Kay. A novice, next but y'all round. Can control your schedule anyway.
he thought about that one.
Yeah, we can, but
he said, "What if it's type of food you never tried before, and you just wanted to try it?"
Nah,
that's bullshit.
KO, as a woman, we can still get a guy like that. Like, oh, I bet he ain't never tried.
Yeah,
I love you
better than sex cake before. Hey, you ever tried this dumb cake? You know, he don't know what the fuck that is. He probably, especially depending on the kind of guy he is. We as females, we can get in like that. So your woman probably gonna trip out on you.
I got a guy like that.
No, KO.
Did y'all ever have a woman that would cook and y'all be like, I can't eat this or whatever. I gotta go eat my woman's dinner.
Nope.
I didn't been around people like that before. It was like, I didn't heard people say, well, men say like, if I don't eat dinner, she gonna be tripping and stuff. Y'all ain't never heard that with no guys or nothing.
I have said that.
She feel like you, Tommy. She said, either way of money being spent on the person, there is no difference. So, Michelle, have you ever walked into the salon and you happen to be at Starbucks on your way to the shop and then you happen to grab your stylist or frappe or something from Starbucks because you was there just being generous because you on your way to the shop? Has it ever happened to you?
Yeah, my clients be grabbing me stuff.
Yeah,
play that shit.
So I've done this.
One of my clients be bringing me stuff.
If it's Marquita in Paris. And I'm feeling Marquita, but you know, Paris, her girl. I'll get y'all both something to drink.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But still with the intent of I'll bring that to work. Hey, I got y'all something. Oh, you so sweet. Or a caller or a text. Her, which I want. Yeah.
You had those intentions though.
Now that's being sneaky.
Yeah.
He had intentions too.
Yeah, but I was single, but the girl wasn't there, so. It was different.
She wasn't?
No, she wasn't.
That didn't stop you, though, did it?
No.
Nah.
It don't
nah.
stop me. Don't stop me. That whole what that man got to do with me shit is real.
Facts. I told you.
Facts.
Like, what that got to do with me?
Oh, yeah, that's definitely real, because you hear that a million times.
I don't know your
You can't even use that excuse. Like, you can't even say, I got a man.
See how you going to me?
Like, I don't care.
Y'all don't realize men how easy men are. I think men are easier than women.
Everybody know men.
Did y'all see the video when the woman walked up to the man and just flipped her phone, turned her phone over like this, and he looked at her, he just grabbed and put his number in there. Y'all go like that.
They had to say nothing.
No. Y'all like when
you say a man ain't able to do that?
No, I'm saying y'all be going.
I'm asking you though.
Let's test
the theory.
Okay.
Yes. I wish I had
camera. I can't do it though.
Yes, you can.
I can't.
He's trying to get back in there.
Oh. No, you can't hear.
You can just tell them afterwards. Be like, this was
a test.
This was just a
joke. We had a little
survey. Thing, we were trying to test out our whatever.
You go get in the house like that. See, Danica said, why would you use better than sex cake as an example? See how bad. How bad you going?
She said that shit good as
like
fuck.
You know you gonna take the cake and do all that. You just going. Y'all don't understand that that's a form of going. Like, I ain't gonna lie. One time I got mad. A motherfucker made a status like, who's selling dinners? Like, you trying to like,
I don't cook.
Oh, you want to show out in front of Facebook like I don't cook and stuff? So I got mad and made a status and said, who can come take my garbage out? Now we at two. Why we at one?
That's so petty.
That was petty, yo.
But don't make it
seem
like I don't cook.
Innocent, though.
Never. You got a woman at home.
I'm right here, so why you ain't asking me? Bae, is you cooking?
That is a
fact. Or I'm probably about to cook. I'm late today. Or I always
cook. If you have a woman, if she don't cook and stuff like that,
that's different. But if you got a woman at home who cook and she feeds you and she do all that, nigga, that's kind of rude.
You deserve to get punched in your lips.
Who making dinners? Oh, so I don't cook around here.
It wasn't intentional.
Yeah, you got me fucked up. So now you know.
He said women are lost definitely easier than men. First of all, the whole generation is lost.
I think he meant most.
Oh, most definitely. Okay, easier than men. That's what you're trying to say.
Oh, yeah, okay, yeah, yeah.
Whoa, he was getting mad. You seen this?
Awesome. I think it's even. I think it's even. I don't know.
Now, you ain't right.
He said, give me $40.
I'm going.
Oh, my goodness.
So, Devin, if a woman just walk up to you and she just turn her phone around for you to put that number in there, you're not going to do it? You and know y'all be going, fine. Y'all be curious too. Like, hold on.
This woman bald? Just fine as hell. Yeah. Just your type from head to toe. You ain't going to give her your number.
No, a girl that took my phone before and just... And typed her number.
Look how you smiling. You like that. Look going at it. Y'all be going.
Like, my phone, but I got
she
it,
said, like, y'all easier than second grade math.
Y'all be going. It's nothing to get y'all to go. Nothing. You literally can turn your phone around.
I can agree with you.
Yeah. For us as females, y'all be just looking shocked, curious, geek, going, smiling, ear to ear.
Niggas be liking that shit. Though.
Come out them boxers, just ready. Like, that's horrible.
Come out them boxers.
Yeah, just be going. That don't make no sense.
What
are
you saying?
Never. Maybe he just wanted you to take a... That's KO. Remember this. KO is saying that.
Damn right I am.
Y'all be going so bad. Oh,
she could take. That's true.
KO, I know a woman could just come up to you, bro, and just turn that phone. Y'all not fooling me. Look at the nigga. The nigga, you been showing the hell out in your past, I see.
I got in so much trouble.
But why you just went?
You get in trouble a lot.
Yeah, but y'all still together? Let's ask that.
But this is the thing.
Right. Y'all still together?
But this is the thing. Like, no. That's her mom on her profile. Okay. So here's the thing. You knew that it was wrong to take the stripper number, but since you going so bad, you still just did it, right? Women, we could turn things down. I ain't gonna lie to you. We can turn things down.
We can
get y'all to spin the block, too.
So many people a day.
So y'all don't think niggas do?
No, I'm sorry.
Not as
much.
Many.
Tommy just...
Nah, I know y'all get hollered at.
Yeah, a lot.
Niggas thirsty as fuck.
Yeah, no.
Tommy's just like, nah.
I seen this dude adding it up. He was like, don't ever think your woman ain't doing nothing or something like that. He was like, if at least four guys hit her up a day, and then four times 7 days a week.
I'll put the like math out there.
10 times in a month.
10 times a month, 10 times a year. He said, ain't no way your woman turning down 1,000 something. Some niggas, but it's possible.
I don't know why people don't believe that. It's definitely true.
Yes, 1,000 niggas is getting turned down a year.
Damn.
Out of 1,000, how many niggas are actually worth actually even looking at?
We saying if you in a
relationship. Actually worth looking at?
Out of 1,000 looks.
Probably 2.
Damn, just 2?
Damn, that's a very low percentage.
Y'all go for all the wrong things. Like, a lot of things don't be attractive to
what y'all
like.
Be going for?
I don't go for shit.
No, I'm saying if
they be going for anything, but I can't single. Go for none of that.
I'm saying if you were single.
What am I going
why
for?
Would I go why would I chase a nigga if I know he's going to come running back?
Can you say another word?
Okay, what?
Why you going to say going? Like I just wanted to drop the E.
What would get your attention?
There you go.
No, I don't know.
She don't want to tell her secrets, huh?
That's a good question.
Smelling good. He's smelling good. He chocolate.
Yeah, because you know y'all can look like y'all smell good. Like we can.
You can look like you smell good.
Yeah.
Okay. Good conversation.
Ask the women. You can like down there look at a man sometimes. Like, I bet he smell good. Like you could tell by how he carry his stuff. You get right past him and he smell good. Like he real clean and put together.
It's a man's presence for me. Like. You can tell when a nigga a peon.
Yeah, she not lying though. Like you can tell he just ain't got no motion. He's soft as hell.
Nothing going on.
He can't lead the way for nothing.
Can't lead shit. You can tell that right away.
Not desperate.
We said y'all probably
we was breaking up.
Turn it down some, but not many.
Mm-hmm. Just stop.
For real.
I'm just cutting up.
I don't know.
All right, easy. Oh, it's a big difference.
What attracts y'all from women? everything.
No, it's a lot of different
things. She walked past and she was a woman. She just was a female.
It could be her walk. It could be
anything because y'all are visual.
Yeah.
Look, y'all be going so bad. Like, I'm telling you, get him a piece of cheesecake and flavor he never tried before or some shit. Like, that don't make no sense. You ready to go.
They say a way to a man's heart is his stomach.
Just ready to go.
Like, damn, you thought of me?
Y'all are so easy, dude. Like, coming
this
up.
Tastes good.
Like, younger days, I did not, you know, I ain't know as much as I do now, but y'all are very, very easy.
The older you get.
Y'all, you just play a different game with the older ones.
It changed.
But the older ones, you play a different game with them.
Which is worse, though, the older men or the younger men?
Shit, it depends on that man, because I done seen some fucking 40-something, 50-year-olds, horrible, just childish. Unstable,
I can't even put a,
no stability at all.
I can't even put a maturity level on,
he said,
on guys because mm-mm. It's some older men that act like kids. It's some younger guys that act like mature. Mm-hmm. They got a lot more going on. Mm-hmm. Then it's like you can find some older and younger ones that's just full of shit on the same thing. And the old ones too, like it don't even be mattering.
If you got a pretty smile and you funny, you can laugh me out my drawers.
See?
It's kind of easy.
She can crack some jokes and now you done went.
But you got, you know, it's got to have engagement.
Now,
I gotta
you know what it
engage.
Is for me?
It's more than just looking.
Careful, you're going back in the house.
A flat.
Flat stomach. Yeah, that's love any girls
stomach.
You like.
I swear to God, I love a flat stomach.
So
I swear.
If she got a flat stomach and big ass legs and shit, you going?
I'm a Curtis.
I don't know. I had to see that.
A botched body.
Right.
I had a chick with a flat stomach and she was dumb as shit.
You learned your lesson, huh?
So after you have fun with her, then it's over with.
No, the conversation is enough to be like.
They say when a man like a woman, like you say, it's like a physical.
It start off physical. Yeah.
It start off like a physical attraction, but after y'all, excuse my language, after you bust a nut, then all them feelings go away. They say,
yeah,
just terrible.
Yeah, be careful. You got just back. Be careful. But sometimes y'all be forcing.
You hear her talking to you?
Who?
Or she talking? Is she talking to when I say older? Who you talking to?
Because Jive Turkey.
Oh man.
Oh, is you talking about from earlier when I said, okay.
Oh, she can't say nothing. She's supposed to be on the show.
Right.
Yeah. We ain't see your comment, Kay. No. Little chicken out. Talking about I was at the shop.
Older chick just sipping paint and
then the older chicks be really spitting G on y'all.
You said, look.
Them older chicks and them real young chicks be having y'all
them
in the
older chicks don't want to go no damn sipping paint. They trying to catch flights and shit. Get bills paid.
Tara like the size old chicks. Nah, nigga.
Yeah, I think you do because they always say that about you.
Nah.
So
I like a petite. I like petite women. That ain't, you know.
So has any chunky women, have any bigger women or thick women ever tried to talk to you? Why are you looking like that?
Yeah, they have.
Say, stop.
Oh!
Yo, I put them in the friends though.
Your wife gonna be a BBW or something.
Never.
Yes.
Never.
You think it's sweet?
It is.
No, it's not. Somebody gonna have you in a chokehold, you gonna cook that cheesecake. Have you in a chokehold, you gonna be somewhere.
You making me want some cheesecake.
For real.
So how y'all feel about that teacher hitting that student with no panties on?
This First is my of all, theory on it, and
we're
I
gonna
said,
talk about the panties.
And I said,
nobody would have known that
I know.
If they hadn't fought.
I feel the teacher is out of order. The teacher was wrong, dead wrong.
Really?
Yeah, I made a status about
the
that.
The girl went like this, and the teacher caught her.
Did you see that before that though? She pushed the little girl too. That's what made
the
little
girl came in her face, and she—that's her reflexes.
Listen. Again. This is what you do. You get on the phone, you know, so you call them people to come get her out
of
the classroom.
Yeah, she could have had, when the girl came in her face first, yeah, it was messy. She could have just,
I walked her to the door, as a matter of fact, I'm walking her to the door. Hey, I need security in here.
But how could you know? Like, you could have
been avoided.
Like, you got a whole classroom.
As the teacher, though, you
got to,
no, you can't.
You can't really say until you in that position.
I used to be a high school principal.
But some kids need.
And I've been in that position
looked,
several times.
Like, stop playing with grown people.
Hold on.
I've been in that position several times. If somebody put my hands on, I don't know what would have happened, but there are like. The way she responded verbally is helped escalate the situation because the girl was talking shit and she started talking shit back. As the adult in the situation, she should not have. But when hands start being thrown, the girl got what she got.
Yeah, I mean, of course, yeah. But
don't put your hands on somebody. There's a way as an adult to de-escalate. I don't think that lady should have beat on that girl like that either, though. But
I mean, the perfect response would be like, "You still ain't got your phone.
De-escalated.
What you doing ain't working. Exactly. I still got it.
Exactly." As a
good luck.
I'm not gonna.
But the cheeks slapping. That was a nice look.
I was disgusted.
Would you let a young man hit
she's
you
little
in your
bit.
Face,
she was too big for you. That's why. See you
would let a young.
I'm
man
not a you. Teacher. Y'all gotta understand. Stop asking me that. I'm
what,
not a
what if
teacher.
You was?
What?
What if you were a teacher? You know you can stop being a barber for 1 second.
Okay. Okay, if I was a teacher, I'm not about to put my hands on no student. I'm just not.
Even if they bust you in your shit.
No, I'm not, because I'm going to lose my job. I'm going to lose my license.
Not if they bust you in your shit.
Yeah, she's still going to lose all her shit. I'm telling you.
That's self-defense.
No, that's
you're going to fucking jail, Devin.
Do you see the lady that
that's
got her leg broke by the girl that she did not fight back?
Somebody at Vincent, one of the safeties at Vincent.
You finna let these kids break your legs.
They're
going to
punish the child, too, but that's. Best believe that teacher gonna get punished too.
Times have changed though; they are a little bit more frequently hitting. The kids are.
He said he would have put one of them kids in an MMA move. I was like, "You going to jail?
You go to jail, Devin.
They gonna book you. They don't even want to know the situation. An MMA.
That's what she said. That's what she told her. She told her to go get her up.
No, she ain't say that.
But no, at the end of the day, man, that teacher was wrong. She could have, you know what I'm saying.
I don't think she was wrong after the girl tried to swing on her. Cause if you hit somebody, nobody finna let you hit them. But before that happened, yeah, she definitely could have handled herself better. She could have de-escalated that. She could have removed herself out of the classroom.
Escalating to that point, then. That's basically what y'all said.
Well,
she ain't the reason why it started in the first place, I guess, because the child got her phone removed.
Okay, which one is more mature, the teacher or the student?
The teacher was supposed to be the teacher, right?
Yeah. Oh, you're saying which one's supposed to be? Yeah, the teacher.
Exactly.
You definitely hired to teach kids, and you know, you definitely an adult, so you should be able to control your anger.
That's
why
I say she's still gonna get in trouble because
easier said than done. Because if a motherfucking kid swing off and hit you in the wrong spot, like in your nose or some shit, you getting hard off and whoop their ass.
Yeah, that's true, but yeah.
No, it ain't true to you because you said no. Kid, you said if they break your the leg, you still not going
to
do that.
Now, if a kid came into the barbershop and was over there, I don't know if he got a gun
What's
or what.
What's the difference?
I'm going to fold his little ass up.
You don't know if they got that
like
at schools.
Michelle said a child had to be in a child's place. That's the problem with these kids nowadays. She said she was trying to avoid the situation.
But you
see, she had a phone in her hand.
No, she was.
I feel like the phone.
No, the teacher, you don't know like the situations leading up to that.
Exactly.
This girl probably be disrespectful every day. Like the girl, the teacher probably be going home like, I want to beat this little girl ass.
That was a day.
Waiting for an opportunity. She probably done told that child's mama all types of stuff.
As a parent, though?
She told her husband.
As a parent, I beat my daughter ass. That's embarrassing.
That is embarrassing.
I'm beating my daughter ass. That is embarrassing.
Because what you trying to get the phone back? Sit your ass down.
Somebody
learn.
Did say it starts at home, but
it
at the same time,
it do.
Your kids could be raised better than that, and they just embarrassing
and
the fuck out of you somewhere in public.
I believe that was a substitute.
You'd be like, where you learn this? I ain't teach you this, or you don't do this at home.
And then them substitute teachers, they really don't be good with the kids.
Mm-hmm. That's why they stuck in the substitute position thing, I think. You're a substitute teacher instead of a real teacher. Like,
she definitely could have de-escalated it starting off from the beginning. But once that little girl tried to hit her.
But I sent another video on YouTube. It was another video where a teacher beat up a student. She beat the shit out that little girl.
It'll be a couple videos.
I'm talking about she was. I thought that was the video. I'm like, oh, she did wrong. As a matter of fact, hold on, I've been looking up and showing y'all. Dog, she whooped this little
girl. There's been a couple videos.
Still don't be learning their lessons after they get that ass whooped.
She was.
They probably still be trying to fight. And
kids,
shit.
Bad.
They do not
now.
Care.
Dude said, "Give me my phone. You ain't take nobody else's phone up in here." And it just went down.
Like, who was you talking to? First?
If you notice, none of the kids, none of the kids say shit. They knew it was up.
Yeah, I wonder what she was doing before that.
Wow.
Because it was a substitute teacher. She probably showed her ass.
Oh, I think this the one. Wait, no.
He said, call CBS in 5 minutes. If it was his kid. Because he said, now it's not about to be pretty.
But what if, like the teacher was punching the girl in her face? That would make you mad watching this grown-ass woman punch
your kid
in the face, regardless of, you know, what your kid did. You still going to feel some type of way about that.
I feel like as an adult, like I said, it could be easier said than done, but I feel like as an adult, you definitely should have a bit more patience when you're working with kids, especially knowing that you're going to run into those type of kids. Like,
mm-hmm. And then these teachers so underpaid. Like,
yeah, like, or find a new field. But you know.
Is they really underpaid, though? Is they really?
Yeah, they are.
It fall, yeah, they, especially nowadays, yes. They've been underpaid since back when I was in school. It falls in the category with people working in a nursing home, but
like
don't like old people.
$40,000 a year or something like that.
I've been out of education for 3 years, and the stress level that I have left behind me is, I did not even know how much I forgot.
For real?
I'm like, man, I can't believe how hard I was working because I don't do shit. Yeah. I mean, I work, but I don't do as much work as I was doing. Like, you get off work, you work all night.
Look, hold on, wait. This the word she be.
Man, never.
Girl, wait.
It says she told her classmates to record before she started talking about the student her classmate spoke of.
Is that YouTube?
Man, yeah. Never. Turn to the camera.
What is it? I can look it up.
She's dragging this kid like it's somebody on the street. She done snap.
What's the title of that?
Look, she's smiling at her. Right.
Oh, she told the classmates to start recording before she started talking about the
She seemed like she said, she told the girl, I'm gonna beat your ass and I'm gonna smile on my
lips. That's this one video right here, though. That teacher just said she in the club fighting.
That's the video that I thought, because I saw this one. I'm like, oh, hell no, she out of order. But then I see the other one. I'm like, oh, okay.
She could have put some drawers on at that school, though. Some stuff, like, because kids are fuck around.
Man. That's how you know that her.
Well, y'all sure she didn't have no drawers her on? Maybe she had a thong on, because she was kind of thick.
Was her skirt just too short or something? Like, you're supposed to dress different.
She
like,
might have had some drawers on. They might have been sucked up in there.
Yeah, she probably.
So, she maybe her dress should have been longer. That's why they say dress appropriate. Like, you at a school. Krishan had her pants wide open at a damn school. Krishan and Blueface looking retarded.
I'm so sick of them. They ain't been in the blogs though lately, but still.
Man, so they've been doing shows, getting bookings. People really booking them.
For real. And I'm like, why?
We're maintained because he had beef. He had smoke for a second. Behind Krishan,
maintained in a couple weeks.
Maintain think he blocked.
He ain't messing with us.
Maintain got mad because I put up a post about the nightlife. You know, so I said they had.
Oh, yeah, I started to read that. They was mad at you.
I said they have to do better because the nightlife been weak. And he got mad about it. But it's like, I'm telling the truth. The nightlife has been weak.
I don't know. I don't go out that much to know what. What's
but
what?
You know the difference from 4 years.
Demanding answers about why a teacher encouraged students to fight inside her classroom.
No, this is the one where the teacher let students fight.
Y'all got 30 seconds.
The district says the teacher was a substitute, and she has now been fired. WFAA's Sydney Persing is in our newsroom tonight after talking to a mother who has video of what happened. Sydney?
Teresa, this mom is mad, and she is not alone. We have blurred every child's face in this shocking video, but I warn you, what you are about to watch is disturbing.
Look how she's saying.
This video is hard to watch and hard to believe. The young boys and young girls you see hit each other hard are only in middle school. the person instructing them to fight.
She's
that is their subject.
She's just chilling.
Unacceptable. It's disgusting. Beatrice Martinez's 13-year-old daughter took this video.
My anger.
And then what if they seriously get hurt? What if they hit their head on the desk or something?
I start seeing
pull up after school with a gun.
Like, why ain't you teaching them? Why are you getting enjoyment out of that?
She not only encouraged her students to fight, but also outlined rules for them to follow. Even made a student guard the door.
Stand by that door and hold it. In case someone comes in.
In the video, you see Martinez's daughter fidget nervously as she records, as Garcia tells her students to put their phones away.
I'm not joking. I'll take your phone to the office.
To make matters even worse, Martinez says her daughter is now receiving death threats for reporting the incident.
I am not going to stand back with my...
Yeah, my bad. Yeah, that was deep.
Yeah, she snapped.
Well, you guys, that's our time.
Is it?
It for surely is.
Yeah, I can't see it up there.
Oh, yeah, it's
hard. Y'all was tuned in this week.
You said I went to her class every day.
Y'all, next week we're going to tell y'all about how we about to go to war with Russia and China. Yeah, because it's getting real and I'm getting scared. It was tuned in this week.
So yeah, we see.
Thank you guys for tuning in.
2 weeks, 2 weeks, because next week, you know.
We're gonna take a break next week Monday, so we'll see you guys the following Monday. Tune in with us, you guys. Put your comments, your thoughts. Let us know what's in your brains as well.
Project, 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 project.